было намного лучше. Ну и на этот раз как-то не удалось. Во-первых, народу мало, музыка не очень.
А что за направление?
А?
Что за направление?
Направление? Какое направление?
What's up guys, Sal here. So Samsung could shock the world. Exynos has been playing the second fiddle to Snapdragon for a few years now, but that could change next year as we have alleged Geekbench benchmark scores of both the Exynos 1000 and Snapdragon 875. If this is true, then Exynos 1000 will not only be faster than the Snapdragon 875, but could also trade blows with Apple's A13 Bionic chip. First up, here are Geekbench 5 scores of Snapdragon 875, 1159 in single core and 4090 in multi-core. That's an improvement compared to 926 and 3452 of Snapdragon 865. The scores of Exynos 1000 are 1302 in single core and 4250 in multi-core. Side by side, you can clearly see there's a big difference, and Exynos 1000 is actually performing around 10% better. Now, if we compare this with Apple's A13 Bionic chip that we find on the iPhone 11 Pro, you can see Exynos 1000 has a better multi-core score while single core is about the same. Of course, A13 is 7 nanometer and Exynos 1000 and Snapdragon 875 are 5 nanometer. A fair comparison would be against the A14 Bionic chip that will be available on the iPhone 12. But according to the latest AnTuTu scores of the A14 Bionic, Apple didn't actually make much significant upgrades in performance and it's about the same. So although I don't think neither Exynos 1000 nor Snapdragon 875 would be able to beat A14 in single core tests, they could very well do it in multi-core, and it's gonna be huge if that actually happens. We'll see once we get Geekbench scores of A14 chip. Now, you might wonder how in the world Exynos got so much better in just a year where it was struggling to compete with Snapdragon 865 on devices like the S20 and Note 20. You might also think, is this even a legit benchmark? Well, I can't actually rule out the possibility of this being not legit, as this is posted on South Korean tech forums and there's no way to confirm its authenticity. But I've been analyzing this for hours, comparing with the official numbers from ARM, and I figured these cores are legit under one condition. Let me explain. Both Exynos 1000 and Snapdragon 875 will use these cluster of cores. 1 prime core, 3 performance cores, and 4 power efficiency cores. It looks like Exynos 1000 is using the Cortex X1 prime core, which is 30% faster than Cortex A77, and that is reflected in these benchmark numbers. Now, the only reason Snapdragon 875 has lower numbers than Exynos 1000 is that they might not be using Cortex X1 cores. Instead, they might be using the custom Cortex A78 Cryo cores, which is 20% faster than the Cortex A77, but performs 10% lower than the Cortex X1 cores, which again reflects in the benchmark numbers. For your information, Geekbench doesn't test the graphics, so these numbers are purely for the CPU. Since Exynos 1000 is still using Mali GPU, it's more than possible it's gonna be inferior to the Adreno in 875. Like I've said, there's no way to confirm the legitimacy of these benchmark scores, but one thing is certain. Keeping these scores aside for a moment, Exynos 1000 will perform at least equal to or better than Snapdragon 875 because Samsung and Qualcomm are using the same cluster of cores. The difference only comes down to which prime core they are using. By the way, Samsung already ditched the Mongoose cores, the primary reason Exynos was inferior to Snapdragon. And if these scores are legit, then Samsung will surely shock the world. Let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.